as soon as the game begins. I bring this up because I really just want to reiterate how well animated this game is. Oh, they made Allura like super cute now. I love it. And then when you first dive into Summer Forest, oh man, the developers totally had to know that these hubs were going to be loved like this. They are absolutely gorgeous and just as fun to explore as they always have been. So the main difference with Spyro 2 comes in a stronger variety of level names and the addition of a challenge-based structure. Each world now has the characters to inhabit it.
Thank you.
well, as have the modifications to the character designs. I was really, really hoping that we would get some sort of level opening and closing cutscenes like in the second game, but we didn't. Fine, I guess we'll keep it faithful. And yeah, once again, I am totally on board with most of these character design changes. They really all do feel like an upgraded version of their original selves, being similar and new at the same time. Like, just look at Crazy Ed. I love him. He's my favorite design. Also, can I get a hello to Bianca, now looking like Lola Bunny from Space Jam? Certainly a whole lot better than...
Spyro 2. Look at how zoomed out the camera is, please. This is what
when questions don't mean it. It's also nice that I get to see this one cutscene actually playing the game. I mentioned this in my Spyro 3 video, but since I don't have the greatest hit version, that cutscene just straight up doesn't play in the first release of that game. So I didn't even know it existed until like a few years ago. And yes, that means the greatest hit version of the soundtrack was used as well. I'm sure that's gonna make a lot of people happy. So as for how Spyro 3 Year of the Dragon was handled, shockingly well. Like I said, this was the one that I was the most worried about. Responsible for this one. Zanzaro Games, the makers of Sly Cooper Games Alive, was brought on board to make all these different gameplay styles. I'm assuming this was just done to speed up the development time. Thankfully, this is a pretty good game. If I'm being totally candid with you, I may end up liking more than Crypto's Rage in this collection. Like the issues that I had with the another classic game getting the remaster treatment. Oh, you're